Hi everyone, welcome back to the Scriptcase macros course. Today we're looking at the scapl conf macro. So this is a macro that allows us to configure different application settings. My name is Nate Carpenter and I'm the instructor leading this course. So as I said before, this allows us to dynamically modify an application's properties on the fly. So here's the documentation for that. So as you can see, you can pass in the application name, the property, and then the value for that property. One important note here is this needs to be done from another application, changing the properties of the application, the target application. So we can do this for a form, a grid, or all applications. So these are some different settings for the form, the start, how it starts, the insert button, the update button, the delete button. We can turn certain fields on and off, and then we can set certain fields to read only. We can determine the number of rows and the number of rows for multiple records there. And then we can also do this for a grid, so the start of the grid, the filter, the columns, rows, and then the edit button, and then we can also modify the exit URL. So here's some examples down here below. I'm going to start with this one, I'm going to copy it, and we can take it over to a Scriptcase application I have set up here. So here is a blank Scriptcase application, and then here is a form that we're going to modify the properties of. So let me run this form so you can see what it looks like without anything modified. So as you can see, it's just a basic form here, set up and ready to go, nothing too special here. So let's go back to our blank application. And this is the application we're gonna use to change the settings of the form. So we need to put that form name in there for the application name. So form underscore actor underscore APL. And the start is new. So that's gonna push it into a new mode automatically. And then we just need to redirect to that form using the SC redirect macro, which I cover in another video. So we get that code finished and then we can run this blank application. And it'll change the property and redirect us to our application, our form. So wait for it to load here, and there is our new form set up in the new mode. So that was automatically set up in the add new record mode for the form. Let's go ahead and take the insert button off of this. So for this, we need to change the start to insert. That's the property we're editing here. So we put an insert there and then turn it off. So we put the off flag in there and then redirect just like before. So run this. And this time it'll just be in edit mode and we can't add a record. So there we go. So we have no add button, just a save and delete button. And we could take those off too in the same way if we wanted to. Now let's go ahead and take one of the fields off. So to do that, we need another option. So the field display off right here, we need to do that. And then we just pass through the field name. So let's go back to Scriptcase here and put that in here. So right here, instead of insert, it's gonna be the field off option. So we copy that in. Make sure I copy that in correctly here, and then we need to pass in the field name here. So we can go over to the form and find that field name. Let's just take the first name field off. So there it is, first underscore name is the name of that field. So put that in there, first underscore name, redirect just like we did before, and go ahead and run this and it should work. So let's run this, and now that first name field should be taken off of the form. Wait for the load, and there we go. So the first name is no longer there, just the last name this time. So that's how you use the scapl conf macro to change an application's properties. As you can see, we have a lot of different settings here that we can change. We couldn't get to them all in this video, but they're all pretty self-explanatory once you find out how to do a couple of them.